Hi, I'm Anduk of Doom, and today we're going to be playing Home. Home is a, well, it says on the screen, a unique horror adventure by Benjamin Rivers. I thought that it would be fun to do this game because we've not really done much of games with an actual story. And also I just found out how to record this game properly. So without further ado, we're going to go straight in and press space. And as it recommends on the screen, we are going to do one whole video of this in a single sitting. Okay, so arrow keys to move, space to interact, and escape to quit game. We're wearing headphones. The lights are off. It is, however, daytime, so that doesn't make much difference, but still. All I remembered at that point was finding myself alone. Oh, my head. Where was I? It was so dark. There was something by my feet. A flashlight. Torch. Alright, we're in the game already. So that wasn't a particularly long intro. Let's look at this potted plant. Apparently we can't. Oh. I have played this game through to completion before, but that was when the game came out, so quite a while ago. That house. Where was I? Oh. There was a body lying on the floor. Who was it? Scared the crap out of me, stupid cat. Let's go all the way to the left before going down the stairs. Oh, computer. The desk had a computer and some papers on it, and a single drawer. I didn't want to snoop, but did I open the drawer? Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Receipts, pens, and a blurry photo. Looked like a store of some kind. Why did this all look so familiar? Blood on the wall. It smelled fresh and sickening. I realized there was blood on my shoes and pants. Trousers! I had to get out of there. Okay, so we're just gonna go back to those stairs now and see what's down there. I noticed that I limped as I moved down the stairs. How did I hurt my leg, I wondered. All I could really recall was coming home, seeing Rachel. I was upset. She looked afraid. I shook my head and tried to clear it. I knew I should head downstairs, try to find a way out. Here we are downstairs. The bookshelf was full of books on local history and hunting. Oh. An old dining table covered in dirty dishes for two people. There were dozens of beer cans and other liquor bottles among the dishes. The smell was turning my stomach. How long had this been here, rotting? The man upstairs didn't look like he'd been dead a long time. What is that? Just rotten food, I guess. Kinda hard to tell. Let's go all the way to the left before choking downstairs. What is that? A thin, grey mouse was stuck in a trap. It looked frantic but exhausted. Did I free it? Yeah, sure, let's go ahead and do that. Why not? Be nice to mice. Ooh, pitchfork. A collection of rusty tools. These looked like they'd seen a lot of use and were caked in damp, smelling dirt. Why weren't they in a shed? That might actually be a rake, not a pitchfork. Thinking about it, I found a picture of a couple. It looked like it had been moved a lot. There seemed to be a switch behind it. Did I push the switch? Always push the switch. It depressed smoothly into the wall. I heard a faraway click somewhere. Man, it's getting all Legend of Zelda on us already. Let's go down the stairs. Ooh, mirror. I looked like hell. My clothes were dirty and torn, and there was mud caked all over my shoes. Okay. It's through here. The bathroom was incredibly clean. Every surface had been thoroughly wiped, and nothing seemed out of place. Oh, what's that though? There was a photo development tray lying on the floor. Some leftover negatives were sticking out, but they were pretty blurry. I thought I saw what looked like treetops. Interesting. Photos of trees. The front door was blocked by a pile of furniture. I knew I had to find another way out. Can you just move the furniture? I know you're like trapped in a spooky house and you're all like traumatized and stuff, but oh! Those jump scares. I think you'd be able to push around furniture. The door was taped up and seemed to be locked. By the smell, I guessed it led to the kitchen. Let's check this last door. May have already been through here, actually. No, we haven't. Okay, that seems to go down. Sure, why not? Let's go downstairs. The box looked heavy, but there were marks on the floor. It had obviously been moved before. Maybe I had found a way out. I must have moved it, right? Yes. I heaved the box forward, and it finally gave. Sweet. There was a ladder going underground where the box was. A dank smell rose from the passage. Did I climb down the ladder? Yes. My leg hurt like hell as I climbed down that ladder. The tunnel below was even darker, and the smell wasn't getting any better. But I had to get out of here, out of there, and find my way home. Footprints in the dirt looked like more than one kind and had a lot of traffic. It was an old map of the town. Places all over were marked. The industrial area near the river, various houses, and even the water tower near the old rail station. The guy upstairs must have done this, but what was his interest in the water tower? It's gonna flood everywhere, man. Newspaper clippings from the local paper. They were all about murders in town over the last few years. Wait, there were photos. Photos of our house. What the hell was that about? Maybe I should have looked around more, tried to find some kind of information. Maybe you should have. A work table, covered in papers, dirt, and a handgun. I hated guns. I didn't take it, did I? Now, do we need a gun? I don't think so. We're not gonna take the gun. I didn't even want to touch the thing. Better I left it right where it was. I think that's a ladder. Might be a bench, I don't know. No, it's a ladder. Dim pixels. The desk looked old and was caked with grime. On it was a stack of old, faded paper, covered with what looked like names. They were scratched out, and illegible notes were written beside them in faded blue ink. I could only make out a few letters. He. Iv. A. H. L. R. Af. Ol. Raw. None of it made any sense to me. That's fine, doesn't make any sense to me either. There looked to be bones half dug into the ground, and the remains looked old. But who put them here? Never gets old. Let's see what's this way. Some kind of homemade rack, slung together with poorly cut wood and rope. It was caked with old blood. Somebody didn't actually use that, did they? Crudely made shelves. They looked like they were holding cans of some kind of corrosive. The labels were worn and slick, but I could still see the warnings. It looked like a cage. It was small, but there was something coating the bottom. Something wet. Imagine that's going to be blood. Let's head down the ladder. Some kind of old boxes. They looked like they were years old. Wait a minute. These boxes had old clothes in them. Clothes I remembered throwing out after Rachel and I moved to town. What the hell were they doing here? The plot thickens. Bats. Go away. I remember noticing the broken ladder. I had to be careful. Okay, there's a broken ladder there. Let's explore this way first. There was a rope hanging there. I wasn't sure how sturdy it was. Did I take it? Yeah, ropes are always useful. Maybe the rope would make that broken ladder easier to descend. Okay, random whispering. Thanks for that. Let's try to get down this ladder. The rope I found would have let me climb down the ladder, the broken ladder, safely. Did I climb down? Yes. Sweet. Got down the ladder. I could hear a faint hum, and the smell from before started to get worse. You knew. Oh, wait, that's not a faint hum. A bunch of old newspapers, wheat pasted together. A message had been hastily smeared on it. Keep out, danger due to cave-in. Well, I guess we're going in anyway. That sounds ominous. My hands tingled from the burn of sliding down that rope. I was lucky I found that. Who knows what would have happened if I had jumped down. Still, it was all I could do to not have rushed out of that awful place. That rack, those terrible tools, what the hell was going on back there? The metal door groaned as I leaned back into it, causing my heart to skip a beat at the sound. As I peered ahead into the dark of the next room, I worried that I should have taken the gun I saw. But me, with a gun. Okay, there's the hum. There was dirt on the ground. It looked wet, and there was grass smeared within it. Someone been, running around? Let's go this way. I could hear a faint trickling sound, like water. What was that? Exit. Yeah, it says exit. There was a rusty ladder sunk into the water, which smelled disgusting. I knew I couldn't climb down that. Maybe I could find a way to drain the putrid water. Okay, so we gotta get rid of all the... Well, I suppose it's sewage. Seems to be some sort of sewage... control thing. Oh, what was that? The door was locked. There was a musty smell from inside. This one isn't locked, however. Ooh. I thought I could turn this water valve to shut off its flow. Did I turn it? Okay. Let's see what this does as well. I wasn't sure, but I thought that was some kind of regulator. I have no idea, or had no idea, how it worked. Good reading brain. Go through door number two. More valves. I thought I could turn this water valve just off its flow. Did I turn it?
Yes.
The valve is still active. Did I turn it again? There we go. Actually, I guess that makes sense. It's got a number 2 next to it, so 2 turns, maybe? That might just be because it's the second room. I'm not going to read that out again, to be honest. Oh, it was 3 turns. I guess I was right then. Yep. Oh, that one was only 1. Okay, maybe I wasn't correct. That was just a coincidence. Oh well, I can pretend. Is it still locked then? Yeah. Yeah, okay, it is. I found actually found a key or anything yet, so. Let's head up here and see if that's got rid of the water. I would assume it has. Great. Speaking of grates, looked like the water drained out of that grate in the wall. Let's press onwards. Ooh, is that a map? The safety poster had definitely seen better days. How old was that facility? Okay, it's not a map then. The door was locked. I could see a faint light within. Let's go up the ladder. Maybe we'll find a key further on. Might have to do some backtracking. Oh, security camera. There was a security camera in the room. There must have been a way to see what had happened. I found another dead body, a sewer worker. He was a mess, but he looked like he'd been stabbed. I could see a key ring that had fallen out of his pocket. Did I take it? Oh yeah. I worked up the nerve to snatch the key ring away and put it in my own pocket. Ah, water. Right. Should we go all the way back to open those doors? Yeah, I guess so. For the sake of completion, I used the keyring to unlock the door. Okay, what is this? Are those videotapes? The shelf was full of security tapes and was strictly organized, though covered in dust. Must have been old if they were still using VHS. Odd, one of the tapes was missing. Pardon me. The security desk was dusty, and there was a dirty coffee cup there. The VCR looked like it still worked. Well, I guess we'll try and find that missing VCR tape then. VCR, VHS, whatever. Shut up. No, I don't want to. Not the paper. Door. Thank you. Let's see if we can open that other one all the way back here. Might find something interesting. You never know. I tried a bunch of the keys on the keyring. I had found on the that's not even a separate sentence. I had found on the sewer worker, and one of them seemed to fit. A collection of stale liquor bottles covered the floor. A faded receipt was half trampled on the floor. It was from the local train station and was for 2 tickets. I didn't know what use it could be, but did I keep the receipt? I don't know if it's asking us, it must be of some importance, I guess. I neatly folded the soiled receipt and slipped it into my front pocket. The wall was littered with dozens of old, faded papers. Whoever did this was obsessed with some local murders. According to some of the clippings, bodies had been found in ravines, in the forest, and in one case dumped in the back of an abandoned truck. I couldn't be sure, but I thought some of these same articles had also been pasted up back in those tunnels. Got some sort of psycho on the loose here. think that's all the locked doors though, so we'll go back through the room. Jump scares aren't cool. Absolute crap there. Yeah. That was really loud as well. Got the volume up quite high. So we haven't found that VHS tape or anything. I could that's really loud. I could smell a hint of fresh air here. Was I close to the exit? I was anxious to leave, especially after seeing what I had. Was there more? An exposed ventilation shaft. Maybe someone crawled through there, but it was so high up. That must have been a sore landing. Oh, I can hear myself again, thanks for that. My sore leg made climbing up the ladder difficult, so I moved slowly up each slippery rung. Who hid all those newspaper clippings away in that locked room? I held onto the ladder with one hand while I fumbled around in the dark, finally catching a heavy latch above me. With it open, I heaved a sturdy lid aside, and the awful smell of that sewer gave way to the dank scent of the pine trees. And we're in the forest. The spooky, dark, misty forest. Wonderful. Just what you always wanted. And quite possibly the most annoying video game door sound ever made. An old ladder leading up to an ancient water tower. The ladder needed to be extended so I could climb it. Did I extend the ladder? Yes. I popped the latch and brought the ladder down. This is the same water tower that was in the newspaper clippings. Maybe. More bats? Let's go up again. Doop-doop-doop-doop-doop. In a patch of smeared dirt and grass, there was a beat-up old wallet. I thought it was mine. Did I take it? Sure. Wallet was missing ID or... ID or card? Alright, I suppose that makes sense too. But it had a bit of cash left in it. I slid it into my back pocket and wondered where my credit card and driver's license were. From the railing, I could see over the woods and down to the entrance to the sewers. Had I come through here before? If I did, someone definitely could have seen me. Dum dum dum. More bat noises, thanks for that. Let's keep going this way. Follow the really badly drawn arrows, I guess. The rusty door was locked tight with an old padlock. The faded sign on the door warned about some kind of train yard. It must have referred to the town's only train station. It didn't look like I'd be able to get through there at all. Unless you have the key. Ooh, sign. This must have been the entrance to the forest that was mentioned on that map I had seen. Whoever was poking around in those tunnels underneath that man's house had scribbled notes on this place, but I couldn't make them out. Here, the sign pointed out various campsites and the walking paths within the woods. It mentioned a river, maybe a washroom, but the rest was too faded to see clearly. Hole in the bushes. Another hole in the bushes, and some immovable rocks. Left or right? I'll go to the left one, because most people probably would have gone straight in the right one, so... Makes sense to try the one that you're less likely to go into. The worn picnic table stood within a circle of trees, like an altar. That's a good comparison there, thanks for that. It was covered in faint markings and carvings from who I assumed were previous campers and hikers. Okay, random water noise. The path ended in a cold-looking river. I wasn't sure if it was safe to cross like this. Did I cross it? Probably not good for our health, but I really want to know what's across the river. Two bodies, two young women, were half dug into a hasty shallow grave between the trees. The younger looking one was still face up, her dead eyes gleaming against my flashlight. I had no idea who these girls were. I didn't touch the gravesite, did I? What does he mean by touch it? I tried to arrange the bodies so their clothes covered them better. I closed the young one's eyes, shivering at this light touch. With a few nearby sticks, I created a head marker so the police could find them later. Well, now you've just put your fingerprints all over them. Such a clever person. Did I wade back over to the other side? Well, I don't think there's anything else over there. Unless we get, unless we get strength, then, I guess we're not going to be able to move these boulders. Right, more boulders this way. What's that? Trampled into the dirt and grass was a plastic card of some kind. I brushed it off and was surprised to see it was my credit card. I wasn't sure if it was still usable, but it was mine. Did I take back my credit card? Sure, we seem to be collecting the contents of our wallet now. I pocketed the credit card. Hopefully I could find my driver's license too. Yeah, it would seem we are. Through the fence I could see a dilapidated outbuilding. I wondered if I could find my way around. Okay. Let's go through some bushes then. Doop 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 doop, bush crawling. Oh, I just heard someone going through the bushes over there. There was some personal effects shoved back into the rock. Wait, there was a notebook there too. Did I read it? Yeah, let's just read it. Inside the cheap dollar store notebook was page after page of names and lists. None of it made much sense. The newest page contained several names. Heather, Olivia, Ashley, Cheryl, Iris, Daphne, Holly, Rose, Rachel. Rachel? Her name was last on the list. I had a mark next to it in blue ink. By the way, I think that was the list, same list that had the bits missing from it before. I think. Might be completely wrong. The names Daphne and Olivia have been crossed out in the same blue ink. Cheryl, Heather, and Rose had also been crossed out, but these marks looked older and more faded. Is it like a hit list or something? Oh, which one did we come? A few embers still burned within the fire pit. I thought of the two girls across the river and had to suppress a shudder. Who else was out in those woods? I really don't want to know. By the looks of it, the fire died out gradually. The cheap dome tent could fit two people. Did I root around inside? Yeah, sure, why not? We'll say yes to pretty much everything at this point, so. Inside the stuffy tent, there were two sleeping bags, still unpacked. Next to them sat two overstuffed backpacks. One was a cheaper looking striped bag that contained women's toiletries and some clothes. And the other looked more expensive, though its contents were similar. The cooler had some ice in it, which had long since melted, and contained only canned beer and easy-to-make food. I couldn't find any cell phones or car keys. Well, is that where those girls were camping before they got murdered? Quite possibly. What is that? Oh, did we find another way around to the outhouse? Sweet, we did. Creepy bathroom. The grimy sink had a small patch in it that looked almost clean. I don't know why I find that funny. There was a damp-smelling plank leaning against the stall door. I might have been able to cross the river with it. Did I take it? I've already crossed the river, have I not? I managed to carry the plank under my arm so it didn't get in my way. Might be able to use it again at some point, though. I've already crossed the river, so... And there was a dead end across the river, was there not? So what's the point in going? Now which... Oh, I should have remembered which bush we came from. It wasn't this one, I guess. The sign was the same as the first one I had seen. This must have been the exit to the other side of the woods. Sweet, found the exit. I had finally found the exit. Once I left, I knew I never wanted to return there. Me too. That door noise. Through the dense trees, I could finally start to see some light. I must have been at the edge of the forest, though I wasn't sure where the path ahead of me led. I could almost feel the cryptic notebook in my pocket as I tried to think about what it could mean. And where were the campers who had abandoned their site? They're dead. We found them, remember? Would I meet them too? Though the path ahead of me was less dense, I still felt guarded and wary. Who knew what was ahead? Right, let's go. Who knows what is ahead? Another horrible door. As I stepped through the gate, I suddenly recognized the auto parts factory where I'd worked as a machinist for all those years. The plant had closed almost 3 years ago now. Times were better then. Topical. I thought I could hear a faint rustling behind me. Maybe it was just the wind. Dum-dum-dum-dum. Oh, there's a hole in the fence, or there's a door. Hole? Door. Hole? Door. Hole? Hole. Oh, God. I found the body of a security guard, just doing his job, no doubt. His face was covered with blood from some kind of head wound. I wondered, was this flashlight his? Dug into the ground was a cracked old watch. First my wallet and now this. Did I retrieve my watch? Yes. The watch was useless, but I put it on my wrist anyway. Why is this guy's stuff scattered all around? Is he the murderer? It's becoming more and more likely, to be honest. Also, everyone else we've encountered has been dead, so, that's fun. Every part of this plant smelled like... It smelled old and rotted. I noticed the old bulletin board on the wall. Ooh, bulletin board. The board contained yellowed clippings of newspaper cartoons and notices. There were notes to and from the guys that worked here. One of them was to Norman, who's one of the older guys on the line. And what relevance is that? Sorry. Our old break table. The layer of dust and grime only made seeing this sting more. Aw. Spacebar! Right, what's that? A power panel. Looked like it was shut off. Did I push the switch? Yeah, whatever. Does have a warning sign next to it, but oh well. The open locker was stuffed with dirty work clothes and old boots. There was a photo of a woman taped to the inside, but it was scratched out, and the face was unrecognizable. Eh. Well, this game's certainly good at building some tension, I guess. A power panel. Oh, it's just the same text. Yes, we'll turn it on. Oh god, that was making a horrible noise. I don't think the last one made that noise. It was shut tight. There was a rusty looking card slot on the side. Oh, we need to go find a card now. Those doors are slightly less annoying sounding. Did we come from upstairs or down? Where did we come from again? I completely forgot. Let's go up and then... I guess it wasn't up then. Let's explore. That door is boarded. The door had been hastily boarded up. Okay, so can't get in there. Unless we find like a crowbar or something. Which would be pretty sweet. This was Norman's locker. The door was dented, like someone had punched it. I don't remember him doing that when we worked here. Ooh, switch. Another panel that I hoped could help me get to the power back on. Did I push the switch? A lot of things in this game make really nasty noises. A utility shelf crammed with mismatched tools and items. There was a claw hammer on the shelf. Did I take the hammer? Ah, yeah, we don't even need a crowbar. We can use a hammer to get, into the boarded room. As I took the hammer, I noticed it wasn't as dusty as the rest of the tools on the shelf. It was, however, covered in blood! No. Maybe that's because someone used it to board up the room. That's, quite possible. The locker was a complete mess. Hidden at the bottom, though, was a magnetic card. Did I take the card? Yeah, we need that. I slipped the keycard into my pocket. Currently, there's not been, like, anything except for the gun, which we haven't taken. So, I don't know. Hey, panel. Let's, push the switch. And the last one over here. Maybe not the last one, in fact, but, actually, those ones aren't green, so maybe... Yeah. I want them to be green. Oh, that one still... Wow. Okay, I hadn't noticed that before, so some of them might just be actually... I just turned them and they just went straight to red. That one's green. I'll have to go back and check some of the other ones, though. I used the hammer. The old wooden boards came apart easily. After I had removed the planks, I left the hammer on the floor. Why would you do that? That might come in handy again. You never know when you might need a hammer, man. This was my locker. There, in the factory, it stank of booze. There was a picture of Rachel on the inside. It looked like it had been torn up. I thought I had taken that picture home when the factory closed. There was a mess of empty booze bottles. I wondered if that man in the house had something to do with this. He sure had a lot of alcohol at his place. There's something suspicious going on with this guy. Now, I need to check these power panels before we actually go on. Actually, we can go through that magnetic, the door that you need the card for anyway. Power panel. Push the switch. Power panel. Push the switch. Well, that seems to be the power back on. Now making a really creepy noise. The keycard I found seemed like it would pass through this reader. Did I use the keycard? Ah, man. Okay, so there's a grate down there. Okay, I guess we're going down there. There was some kind of ventilation hatch there. It looked like I could jump down to the room below. My leg hurt enough as it was, but I couldn't see another option. Well, there might be an object we could find to, like, because you know how we found the rope and then there was the board to get us across the river, but I think we're just gonna jump because I can't be bothered backtracking, mostly. Oh man, my leg hurt like hell. Yeah, imagine it would. That actually seemed like quite a long drop. There was a crumpled up letter on the floor. It had been scratched out heavily, and it was hard to make out. Did I try to read the letter? Don't see why not. Most of the letter was violently scratched out with what looked like to be a ballpoint pen. All I could make out was, need to... Just don't. Drinking. Need. Norman. Who was Norman writing to? Well, I imagine he was writing to either you, if you are the murderer, or the murderer, to tell him to stop drinking and just don't do something stupid or something like that. I don't know. It's all speculation at the moment. Carefully stepped out of the factory, unsure of what I might find. One thing still bugged me, though. Who'd been drinking in that locker room? Was it that guard I found outside? Or maybe Norman? He and Rachel are friends. Maybe he could help. I knew he lived above the store he ran now. Maybe that was where I would go, if I could make it there on my damn leg. Oh, wonderful, in a spooky forest again. He doesn't actually look like he's limping now when he's walking. I don't know if he always did, but... oh well. Let's go through this fence. What is that noise? Yay, garbage bins. The garbage bin was a disgusting mess of rotten food and slick, black bags. I saw a thin, greenish corner poking out from one of the bags. It was my driver's license. It looked damaged. Yeah, let's take that. I cleaned the card off as best I could. It looked pretty beat up. I was amazed to have found my credit card, and now this. And the watch, don't forget the watch. I tucked the card into my wallet, next to my credit card. Actually, didn't you find the whole wallet itself as well? It sounded like it was going to start raining again. Like, oh, it had like a piano thing just for DUMM, it's going to rain. There's got another one there, see? It might actually just be for every chat thing and I've not been paying attention. I had entered Norman's place. This was the back of the store that he ran. Really close to the factory. That's a bit too convenient, maybe. It was oddly quiet, except for the faint sound of a television. Yeah, let's just break into his house then, I guess. That's cool. The entrance to the front of the store was locked from the inside. Looked like I couldn't just pop it open. It needed a key. There's a bit of blood on the keyhole. Oh. Ooh. Oh, there's blood all over the floor. The TV still flickered some indecipherable channel. Oh, Norman. Jesus, I couldn't believe what I was seeing. Norman, my co-worker, and one of the few friends I had in this town, lay dead beside his armchair. His face and shirt were covered in blood. It looked like he'd been killed trying to get up. His eyes were still wide with shock. Norman, you deserve better than this. Did I close his eyes? Yes. I wasn't sure if I wanted to give him peace, or if I just couldn't stand to think anymore about what was going on. Quickly, I closed Norman's eyes. Ow. Table. I guess this was Norman's kitchen table. He kept it clean enough, but there were water rings from two cups still there in the wood. Who was he talking to? The kitchen trash bin smelled fresh. I didn't dig through the mess, did I? Well, you've already dug through one bin, so... I found a hairpin amongst the rotting food and trash and pocketed it. Why? Oh, you can pick the lock. That's what you can do. Oh, I want to check the fridge. God damn it. You'd think you'd be hungry after all this walking. What's that? What was this? It looked like a pull chain hanging from the ceiling. I wondered where it led. Oh, secrets. Pull the chain. And give the chain a single tug, and a simple folding ladder to the attic popped down. Do we want to go up into the attic? I suppose so. Tucked against the wall were an old sleeping bag and a portable camping stove. The sleeping bag smelled earthy. Had it been used recently? Norman, were you in those woods? There was a large cardboard box that hadn't been sealed. Did I open it? Yeah, why not? Inside the old cardboard box was a pile of clothes, photos, and even shoes. As I looked closer, I realized they were Rachel's. What were you doing here, Rachel? Were you responsible for poor Norman downstairs? You should be blaming everyone now. So much suspicion, man. Let's check what's through this door. A coat. I wasn't entirely surprised to find this here. It was one of Rachel's old fall coats. Autumn. I always wondered what happened to it. How long had it been there? There was a well main. There wasn't a well. There was a well-maintained cabinet, gun cabinet here in Norman's room. I didn't know much about guns, but it looked like he kept a few hunting rifles and maybe even a few pieces he couldn't have. A few pieces? What? He shouldn't have. All right, so one of the guns was missing. I mean, actually, that could be the murder weapon, but then also he said quite early on that one of the guys was stabbed, so that wouldn't... If he had a gun, I don't think he would bother stabbing him unless he didn't want to make much noise. Well, I guess that's what stealth games have taught me. right, so we should be able to pick lock this, I guess. I used the hairpin to pick the lock. That's actually not as easy as it's made out to be in movies and stuff, by the way. Not speaking from experience, but still. The hairpin snapped in half, so I threw it away. The general store was small, but it was clean. It had the usual things, postcards, snacks, magazines, and canned goods. I never went there much. Rachel usually stopped by after work if we needed anything. The register was mostly empty, and a fat stack of travel magazines sat beside it, even. Ooh. I'm still surprised he's not trying to get any food. The icebox seemed to have been unplugged. Or seemed to be unplugged. It must have been off for a while. Most of its contents were half melted. There were various postcards from the area, especially from the tourist traps. One of the postcards showed an old black and white photo of the water tower. It looked to be in much better shape then. Pardon me. That night continued to take horrible turn after horrible turn. It had been weeks since I'd last seen Norman, but to find him like that. Who could have done that to him? Seeing that dusty box of old clothes was a shock. How long had they been there? And what was Rachel doing at Norman's place? I felt like I had only discovered more questions, no answers. But I was close to home. It was time to find out the truth. Okay. Let's find the truth then. I just want to go along and see how far along you can actually go, but I think it might be looping now actually. Yeah, I'm fairly sure. Or maybe it's not. No, it's not at all. Oh, is this the right gate? I guess so. Wait, what? The neighborhood local post box. A letter was sticking out, as if someone hadn't pushed it all the way in. I knew it wasn't right, but did I look at the letter? Yes. Reading other people's mail. It's a good pastime. The envelope was addressed to Norman. There was no return address, but the handwriting looked familiar. I took a deep breath and tore open the package. The letter read, Norman, I'm sending this to you in a letter because I'm afraid to tell you this in person. What we did, well, it was wrong. My husband isn't an easy man to be with, but he is my husband and your friend. I need some time to sort this out, away from you both. I'm going away for a while. I'm going to tell him, Norman. So don't you think you can hold that against me? I'm going to tell him and get past this. Maybe we'll work it out. I'm not sure I even want to, but he deserves at least that much. Goodbye. Oh, okay, so... She told him that she was having an affair with Norman, then he went berserk and went on a murderous rampage. All makes sense. Not my house. Do you actually walk faster when you... No, you don't, okay. I thought you did for a second there. It's the wrong gate. And there's the correct one. I had entered our backyard. The rain gave me a terrible sense of foreboding, and it chilled me through my clothes. I was expectant, but also afraid. Dum dum. I held my breath as I approached our back door. I was terrified to step inside. Dum dum. All this blood everywhere as well. Wonderful. This could only end terribly. The house was painfully quiet. The only sound was my own breathing, ragged and strained. I flicked the light switch by the door. The power was off. Oh yeah, well obviously. The table was clean. It hadn't been used any time recently.
Water.
Okay. Let's see what's through this door. Okay. It was locked. Where did I put the damned key? Where's the damn key? We'll explore all this way first, before we go upstairs. There was a small pile of mail on the floor, in front of the mail slots. How long had I been away? Why hadn't Rachel picked this up? Most of the contents were bills. There was a credit card bill there. Did I open it? Yeah, sure. I ripped the bill open and read it. To my surprise, it said something about cancelling my credit card due to non-payment. What the hell? The front door was locked from inside. I couldn't go out through. Oh, though. My inability to read, there we go. I needed to see if Rachel was here. Sorry about that. Let's go upstairs. And, oh, this one's stuck as well. There was an old-fashioned keyhole underneath the handle. Well, if we still had that hairpin, then, never mind. Oh. An old photo of Rachel and me stared back at me, reminding me of better times. It didn't make me feel terribly comfortable. Did I keep it anyway? Yeah, sure. That seems like something you might have in your wallet. Oh, it actually says that. I replaced the photo in my wallet, feeling like I had got part of my life back. Still, that image made me uneasy. Why had I thrown it away? Our television. I had purchased it before I knew I was going to lose my job. I felt pretty guilty about it afterward, but by then it was too late. Ah, water. Okay, have we explored this whole bit? Did we check here? I kind of forgot. Yeah, it's locked. Let's go even further upstairs. And this guy's got a pretty big house actually. For some guy who worked at a machine. Well, actually, it doesn't tell you what he did at the factory, so he might have been like a big manager or something, but still. The books there were half of mine, half Rachel's. Hey, now that I looked more closely, it looked like that man in that house had some of the same books as I did. My wife's, Rachel's suitcase, was sitting on the bed. It was closed, but I had a feeling what was in it. Did I open it? Yes. Inside Rachel's suitcase was a few days' worth of clothes, some personal effects, and a train ticket. I stared at the ticket, and I could feel myself flush with anger and resentment. The date and time matched the receipt I had found. Yeah, it's all coming together. All coming together. Our hallway mirror had been smashed, its pieces scattered around the floor. Our sink, which needed to be replaced. One of the taps always stuck, but I hadn't got around to fixing it yet. We were lucky enough to get a house with one of those wonderful old claw-footed bathtubs. Well, that was a useful room. right. Let's check this one. My laptop had been left on, and only had a tiny bit of power left. On the screen was a website about the old water tower. There was a key in the top of my drawer desk. Did I take it? I pocketed the key. Is that for the, The locked door downstairs, probably. The one to the right here. The door was stuck shut. There was an old-fashioned keyhole underneath the candle. Okay, I guess not then. I did take the key, didn't I? Where's that key for then? Is there a basement? Something I've missed? I unlocked the basement door. All right, okay. There were old Christmas decorations in the box. The garbage bags were stuffed with old paint cans and supplies. There was a dirty old key there. Did I take the key? Yes. I took the small key and tried to remember what I unlocked. I know, I know, I know, I know, no, no. It's the one up here. The grimy key I had found in the basement unlocked the door. It looked like the room had been tossed around. The furniture was a mess, and did somebody break in here? There was an old crowbar on the floor. Did I need to take the crowbar? See, I knew we'd be at a crowbar at some point. I lifted the heavy crowbar. I appreciated its weight. The space. There we go. Right, so let's check the rest of this basement. Because we never actually finished checking that. There were old clothes, tools, and obviously other things we. There were old clothes, tools, and other things we obviously hadn't thrown out yet. Oh, what's that? The crowbar I found would be sh have been strong enough to burst through that cheap wall. Did I break through the wall with a crowbar? Why would you. Right, whatever. Let's do it. With a heave, I swing the crowbar at the wall. I smash a hole large enough to step through. As I stepped through the broken wall, my breath caught in my throat. This was it. Was Rachel down there? Was she okay? A filthy looking pile of rags had been dumped in the corner. The stench of them was awful and made my eyes water. I was terrified to even touch the pile, to see what lay within, but I knew I had to. I had come this far. After all this searching, after all I had seen, when I looked within the rags, did I finally see my Rachel? You're giving me an option for this. Yes? It was worse than I could have possibly imagined. Within the folds of that rotten smelling heavy fabric was the pale, dead figure of my darling wife. What struck me most was that she wasn't bloody or torn apart, rather she was covered in sickly green bruises and her windpipe had been crushed. The real horror was that whoever had killed her had done so intimately with bare hands. So this is what had been gnawing in the back of my mind this whole time, what I was afraid of. I thought about all I had seen, and wondered if any of it could help me figure out who had done this. And when I couldn't stay there any longer, I stepped away on my shaky legs and made my way back upstairs. Reluctantly, exhausted from my journey, I could no longer resist the urge to close my eyes. Maybe I would use some of Rachel's travel books and find some place to go. Within the few broken pieces that remained of that mirror, I could see my face grown pale and weak. I couldn't bear to look again. It was like I didn't actually expect a reflection. I felt empty and drained. From from now on, I'd have no one to get angry with me for stupid things like buying this TV. Didn't actually mean to go into that room. The mail still sat there, heaped on the floor. How long had Rachel been lying in the basement? I couldn't leave, not until I had thought about this some more. I needed answers. Okay, actually, I thought we were just meant to leave, but apparently we can find some answers. There would be no more dinners here, no more chit-chat over breakfast, at least not for us. I must have locked the door, there was no reason to return to the backyard anyway. I couldn't go back down, not until I'd gone over everything. I needed to make sure I was perfectly clear. My old office safe sat on the floor. I used to keep tax records and other important documents in it. I used a digital passcode lock. Did I try to open it? The safe used an 8-digit code. What was that damn code again? I don't know the code. No, that wasn't it. Damn, I couldn't remember. Oh man, I must have missed the code somewhere. I leafed through the notebook I had taken from the forest. In it were the names that had been written down. Heather, Olivia, Ashley, Cheryl, Iris, Daphne, Holly, Rose, Rachel. Those poor girls, were they victims of the same person who had killed Rachel? I wondered what had happened to the other names on the list, or the ones scratched out on that desk in those wet tunnels. The reflection in that grimy glass was only a shadow, a whisper. I still loved the old-time charm of that clawfoot bathtub, though it seemed like cold comfort then. It was the key card I found in the factory, the one that allowed me to slip through that door. It seemed to me that it was probably Norman's. But if that was true, what was he doing back at the plant? Did I think Norman was going back to the factory? No, why would he be? No, somebody else was using that locker room. But who? The laptop had finally run out of power. We need to find some answers here. Have we examined all the evidence yet? It was my wallet, with its contents intact. Either I dropped that stuff or somebody else did. Maybe I was sleepwalking again, or maybe somebody stole it from me. Norman's store, that forest, the water tower. Was I at those places before? Yes. I didn't see how it could have happened any other way. I must have been the one to lose my wallet and its contents. But what does that mean? It means you're the murderer! God damn it! No matter what, I needed some kind of escape. Well, I'm glad I didn't take the gun, otherwise this guy probably would have shot himself by now. I've already checked this room. Could we leave now, please? Just thinking about things like that made me sick with grief. It seemed like I had seen all there was. Maybe, I thought, I was ready to go back into the basement. I guess I was ready to face the truth now. I couldn't go back into that room again. What else am I meant to do? What? Doesn't make any sense. I need to put an end to this situation one way or another. I just said you were... What? That doesn't make any sense. It's like, yeah, I need to end this in the basement. There's nothing to interact with except that door and he won't go through it. It seemed like that mail had been there for a while. That was it. With Rachel gone, I couldn't stand to be in the house a moment longer. Did I leave and say goodbye to that nightmare forever? Yes. Since I had arrived in town, things had been difficult. Working in the plant, though, had been good for me. It kept me in line, gave me something to do, and helped me get away from my past. When the factory closed, everything changed. I guess that was when I had started sleepwalking, disappearing for hours at a time. Drinking was probably just a way to deal with that. It was almost as if trying to beat my brain at its own game. Things stopped making sense sometime after that, and my memories of what happened are still in flux. But I know Rachel had tried. I know she had tried to be there for me, even when everything was falling apart. This night had unearthed terrible truths, and I knew it was a final act of a long-standing horror I'd been living. Waking up in that house tonight was the final cruelty. I wish I had remained unconscious in that room forever. Even the man I had found in that old place was a mystery. Why he was dead, or who had done it to him, was not something I could even begin to understand, or why, for that matter, I was in that damn room in the first place. Whatever happened, I knew at least that Norman wasn't the one who kept going back to that factory. I hoped it meant that he had nothing to do with that guard's violent end. But who had been rooting through those lockers, or drinking in that boarded-up room? I had to catch my breath, to take it all in. Up until the factory, things had only gotten worse. But then I had seen something I wouldn't have expected. When I went to Norman's store, that's when my perspective on all this really started to change. Norman was dead, but I had no idea what happened to him. Finding Rachel's thing at his store, though, had been the ultimate shock. I would get no answers now, but that didn't stop my head from reeling with questions. But as painful as all of that was, oh God, I couldn't bear to think about it again. After all I had done and seen, finally coming home was supposed to be the end to this entire ordeal. God help me, though. It was only the beginning. As I swung open the door and stepped out into the air, I caught the scent of wet grass and fog. Rachel, my beautiful wife, just the thoughts of her again, cold and inert, shook me from head to toe. What would I do now? Who could I turn to? It would only be a matter of time before the police got involved. Before the neighbors knew. The front lawn was soft and giving beneath my feet, and I couldn't shake the urge that I shouldn't stand there, but rather that I should run. Thank you.